Hello everybody and welcome to Bull Technology. So today is a little bit different of a video and I just want to use this opportunity to demonstrate a lot of the problems that plague Windows 10 and the direction that Microsoft has gone with the Windows brand. It's no secret that I really don't like Windows 10. I'm not a huge fan of Windows 11. I've had a lot of experience with older versions of Windows, Windows 8, Windows 7, Windows Vista, Windows XP. And I think Windows 10 is probably one of the worst iterations of Windows that Microsoft has ever come out with. I say that because there's a lot of issues with Windows 10, design inconsistencies, repetition, features not working, and not a lot of continuity across the operating system. And so what I'm going to do today is first use one application to demonstrate a lot of the issues that Windows 10 has. And again, I should just preface this by saying I know Microsoft is now focused on Windows 11. I've played around with Windows 11 a bit. It has improved in some areas a lot. In other areas, it's gotten worse. They've put more of a focus on having a walled garden. And things are, you know, again, heading in the direction that I'm not a huge fan of. So let's first of all take a look at one application that demonstrates a lot of Windows 10's issues, and that is the Windows Photo application, which is built into every installation of Windows 10, whether you want it or not. There's a lot of issues with it. So I have a screenshot here. This is a 1440p JPEG image, or excuse me, PNG image. I took this in Minecraft, and I took this probably about 2 hours ago, and I just wanted to quickly do some adjustments to it so I could send it to my phone and send it to some friends so I could explain some things that are going on in our Minecraft world. Pretty geeky, I know. But so here's the image. You can open it in the Photos, and this is what Windows Photos looks like when you open it up. Now, the first thing you'll notice is the user interface. You have these incredibly large buttons, these big square buttons that run across the top and down here in the bottom. And you notice that this is obviously designed for touchscreen users. A button does not need to be this big, but it is designed this big so I can touch it with my finger, right? And there's a lot of iconography, a lot of simplicity, and okay. This is my first issue. People that are desktop users do not need this much wasted space for simple buttons. And there's a lot of examples of this all across Windows 10. I'm just going to open up the settings screen to explain this. Now I'm going to have to blur out some of my personal information, but you can see the same type of design used in system settings. This is very obviously designed for touchscreen users. These buttons are massive. You don't get a lot of information, very simplistic. And I would just want to parrot this with how settings used to look on Windows. So this is the control panel, which is largely designed off Windows 7. And you get different subsections, links that tell you exactly what you get when you click on them. And this is obviously more geared toward keyboard and mouse users. And I find this to be much more efficient if you're on a desktop. This is obviously great if you're on a touchscreen, but I feel like most of the people that are using a Windows device or either on a laptop or a desktop. Hi everyone, so this is me in post-production, and I just wanted to back up this claim with this great Windows Central article that found that even users that have a touchscreen on their laptop, most of them do not use the touchscreen. They just use the trackpad. So again, it feels like Microsoft is gearing Windows to a user base that really doesn't exist on the platform. So, and also notice that even in Windows 10, where they're pushing this design user interface, you still have crap like this lingering around. So here's again an issue of design inconsistency. This looks nothing like this, yet both of them exist, and there's a lot of redundancy in these system settings. So some of the settings are here, some of the settings are here. To get to an exact setting, you need to find it. It's a mess. There's no continuity, there's no consistency. I'm given this, and a lot of this exists through the operating system, where there's a lot of the Windows 7 and Windows XP style bleeding through, and there's a lot of this funky new UI, and there's a lot of disconnect between the two. This exists all across the operating system, and we see that clearly here in Windows Photo. This is the new user interface. All right, so you can add, you can see I can make albums, I can, you know, import photos, do all that. That's pretty common for a photo editor. I would just like to interject again, because I know a lot of people will probably say, well, you can install any photo viewing or album application that you want, but I think that the default photo application says a lot about how much that operating system or that company cares about quality and consistency, and it's really paradigm for the rest of the operating system. But something else that you can do in a lot of photo editors is edit images. And so what we're going to do now is show some of the editing capabilities built into Windows Photo. And you can see, well, you just saw there, but I'm just going to go ahead and say that the people that designed this app either didn't put a lot of polish into it, didn't put a lot of time into creating it, or they just didn't care. And I don't know what it is, but every operating system, whether it be mobile, desktop, whatever, has some kind of built-in photo editor. And all of them are better than this. And so let me show you why. First of all, I can crop this image, right? I can do this in any photo editor. So I'm just going to crop it a little bit. And then I want you to notice what's happening when I pan around with the crop. Notice how, and it's not frozen. It's just so incredibly lagged. There's such a frame rate issue for rendering. Again, this is not some 5K raw image. This is a PNG 1440p screenshot. And this is real time. So you can see how unincredibly optimized the Photos app is. I mean, this is chugging. And what's I should preface this also by saying this machine is not a slouch. This is a Ryzen 7 1700X running at 3.9 gigahertz. That's an 8-core, 16-thread CPU. I've got 16 gigs of RAM and a GTX 1060 dedicated 6-gig graphics card. And this is the performance that I'm getting. Not a good look. Also, I am given the option to straighten the image, which is great, right? I can straighten the image. That's usually, it's usually what you want. But a couple of things. I can't enter an individual value. You can see I can't, it's set at 2 degrees, but I can't, you know, click it and then enter 0 on my keyboard to get it back to normal or whatever interval I want. Also, the biggest issue is they're not giving you any distortion effects. You're only given the very basic straightening effect. Even iOS on my iPhone gives me the ability to distort the image. And what I mean by that is I can straighten it left and right. I can't straighten it top down. And now why would I want to do that or distort the image? Because you can see this image has an angle to it. And if I wanted to make this square, bend it out, and, you know, correct it, well, I'm not going to be able to do that here. You know, I can straighten it, but I can't distort it at all. So that's kind of a failure. I can rotate it, obviously, like most photo editors, and do a flip. That's all pretty basic. Notice how the buttons are, again, inconsistent across the same friggin' app. I'm given these small, rounded buttons. This is kind of similar to what you'd see in Mac OS. This is more appropriate for a desktop. But then look at the buttons up here. They're large, they're square. And this is obviously inconsistent with this. You can see the curved edges. You can see the size difference. Just something to keep in mind. And this is all across Windows 10. But now let's move on to filters. So the filters, this is, again, I don't use filters in pretty much any photo editor. My main photo editor is Affinity Photo. But I can add a filter, and here's probably the biggest issue, which is I can click on a filter, but I can't adjust the individual values of that filter, and I really have no idea what is being manipulated with that filter. You know, when I press on a filter on my iPhone, I'm given options to adjust. It's telling me what's going on, right? It's telling me, okay, it's adjusting the saturation, it's adjusting the brightness, the tint, whatever it might be. Here, I'm only given filter intensity. And of course, I can bring it back to normal if I want. What's interesting is that there actually are individual adjustment values, but they're just under a second panel and they're hidden under these arrows. So you can see I can adjust the contrast independently. I can adjust the exposure independently. I can adjust the highlights. But where I would want to do that when I'm selecting a filter, I can't do that under the individual predetermined filters. So again, just something that I don't think was thought through when this was designed, and it's frustrating. Also, something I'd like to comment on is the fact that in order to bring this back to normal, I have to press on original, whereas under adjustments, I press a separate reset button. Just, again, I know I'm being repetitive, but design inconsistencies. And you can tell that this is clearly, again, geared toward touchscreen. I mean, there's no reason why this needs to be a scrolling page. I mean, it goes from the top of my display down to the bottom. They could compact this because, again, look at how small my cursor is and how much wasted space there is here. It's just, again, poor design for, I think, the vast majority of people that are going to be using Windows 10. This is, again, look at it. So that's Windows Photo. This is one of my main issues with Windows 10, is you're seeing it. Design inconsistency, it's geared for users that are not the dominant user for Windows. A lot of clunkiness, a lot of unoptimization, things like that. I mean, within this one app, I'm given three different options, a reset button here, click on original here, and a reset button up here. I'm given three different options to bring the image back to its normal state. I just wanted to make this video to, again, demonstrate that I think Windows has become just a hot mess. It's clunky, it's inconsistent, and these are things that I really hope that are resolved in Windows 11 or are patched in Windows 10. And just again, for example, there's a bunch of other issues I have. First of all, like all of the pre-installed crap that Microsoft installs on your PC. Now, you know, a lot of this stuff I don't want, but Microsoft, you know, force downloads it on your PC. There are apps that can stop this from happening, but by default, this really shouldn't be the case. You know, if you're paying for this operating system or you're buying a computer with Windows 10, that kind of stuff shouldn't happen. Also, the telemetry, weird crap like this that I don't think anyone asked for. I mean, this is unimportant. And so this video is not to heap scorn and ridicule on Microsoft, on the Windows team. It's just to express some of my frustrations with this operating system and issues I have with the direction that they're going. So be sure to leave a comment, because I'm all for having a discussion with you guys if you have disagreements, anything like that. But I just wanted to make this video to, again, demonstrate some of my frustrations. So be sure to leave a like, a comment, and definitely subscribe. And thank you all for watching.